All right, we're live. Hey, yo, welcome to Culture Vulture. It's your boy.
Squaw!
Squaw!
Got your boy, Duche Holmes, a.k.a. City Magic, a.k.a. the Vulture, futuristic Voltron, a.k.a. Purple Rooms.
And it's your boy, Trav, you know what I'm saying? A.k.a. June, a.k.a. Mr. Lavender. That's what we're going to call ourselves today.
Hey, Mr.
Lavender. In the Purple Room.
In the Purple Room today. And this is...
Culture Vulture. So we're gonna get into some new stuff. Pretty much current events, all the hottest songs out right now, and two new joints on our countdown. That leaves you guys with seven songs that are brand new. And let us know your feedback. You know, get back to us and everything. And we're gonna take it from there.
And then we're gonna let you hear a new trailer for a dope film that's coming up. And then we're gonna put somebody on blast with this week's bird of the week.
Ah, squad. Let's get into it, man.
So, right now with the current events, you know, Golden Globes was last night.
That was lit.
That was kind of crazy. Did you peep the way Leonardo DiCaprio?
It was like he was in a part right then and there. Are you talking about when he accepted the award or when he was like sitting there?
When he was sitting there, and Lady Gaga walked by, and she like brushed his back, and he looked like
he was horrified.
Like somebody dripped garbage down the back of his neck. You know what I mean? He's
oh man, it's weird to see celebrities treat each other like that, right? Like,
I mean, like, yo, Lady Gaga, like, her persona is kind of crazy. Like, you don't know, I don't know. Like, Leonardo DiCaprio, he could be, I don't know what he's like. You know what I'm saying? He could be real tight. He's never won an Oscar. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Lady Gaga out here winning Golden Globes is her first role. Everybody knows her because she.
And you know what? I don't know what role she did. What is that?
What role? That's a good question. I don't really know what role she was in. I know it was like a new show that just came out.
Oh.
I'm gonna hit the Google for that.
Was it the one with vampires? It probably is. I think I seen something new about vampires.
I don't know exactly what it was. I'm Googling her right now. Lady Gaga won a Golden Globe. Oh yeah, everybody's talking about her, about their reaction to her. But it was her role in American Horror Story. Okay. Have you ever seen American Horror Story?
I've caught it on occasion. Nothing crazy.
All right, so for those of you out there who don't know what American Horror Story is, American Horror Story is this Draga TV show that's supposed to be like a... It's like...
Trash.
It's trash. It's a scary movies TV show. Every season, they have a new... It's a new storyline. So I seen the first season in its entirety. It was like a haunted house. People were coming back from the dead. Like, if you died on the house property, then you were still a ghost. And it was, yeah, and it was ridiculous.
Yeah.
But then in the second, third, and fourth season, it became a musical, a horror musical. You're looking at me crazy.
How does that work? Like,
I don't.
Was that part good? Was that part of the show good? The musical, I'm trying to picture that.
Nah, the musical was Draga also.
Trash.
I'm giving it a buck, yeah.
Oh, man.
But there was a number of different winners from the Golden Globes last night. I know Leo pulled away Best Actor in a Drama and a Motion Picture. John Hamm got the heads up for Mad Men.
Mm.
He's been skipped tough. Over a couple times. That was tough. You seen Taraji win?
Yeah, and you know what? I'm not an Empire fan. I'm sorry if this is like being Debbie Downer kind of energy, but I'm not really an Empire fan.
Do you like Power?
I do like Power. That's one of my favorite shows.
Isn't that crazy? That's one of my favorite shows. The two shows that people always say with each other. It's like, do you like Empire?
And you know what? They kind of shaded 50 in that situation.
True.
Let's be honest.
True.
Like, that's crazy.
True.
They shaded 50. So, I mean,
50's been going.
I was a little shady about the situation. I felt some kind of way.
Yo, how she gave up? She was handing out mad cookies.
Yeah.
The girl's lick. Yeah.
Who's she? Patti LaBelle?
I don't know. But I know that she's been on it since Hustle and Flow, though. Like, now
that's a great movie.
She was popping. She's been popping.
And she's gotten many little segue moments from that. You know what I mean? She moved on to doing Baby Boy's first. Yeah. But other things, yeah.
Yeah, other things.
Empire is one of her biggest things to date, so.
So
shout out to her.
Rest in peace, David Bowie.
Yeah, died at 69.
Died at 69, just dropped a new album. I'm not going to lie, they're saying that the new album was prolific. I heard a little bit of it. I wasn't really...
But is it your taste, though?
It was like rock, jazz, classical, crooning. I don't know. He dropped this like horror mystery song, like this crime mystery song.
I would have to hear it. Wow, that sounds...
Your man's wasn't really feeling it. Yo, so tonight... moving on with current events, and this will be like our last little topic before we move on to the countdown. Trav's got a dope countdown for y'all. So tonight's supposed to be the State of the Union address, the last State of the Union address by Mr. Obama, President Obama. How do you feel about that?
You know, throughout his presidency, I've kind of had a mixed opinion about him. I mean, there's been times I bashed him. There's times that I thought he did a good job, or certain things that he was very fair about, or very like on our side about. But overall, I mean, like, I don't.
What do you mean, our side about?
I mean, I'm talking about in general here, not even like color specific.
Okay.
But like, yo, seriously, like a lot of things that like people try to bash him for were the things that I felt he did a good job. And it's the things I was like, oh no, that was like a poor way of handling something. Like everybody else is like, no, he's the greatest ever. So I mean, like, it's like a mixed bag. But I do know I'm not voting Trump. So I want to put my political stance out there early. I'm not voting Trump.
There's still so many people you could vote for, but nevertheless, they're saying that this is going to be his speech where he talks about the state of the country in general. A lot of times, when a president is about to leave office, they use their State of the Union address, their last one, to talk about all of the policies that they would like to see happen for the year. I don't think he's going to do that. I think he's going to talk about more of the things that he was talking about on the campaign trail, about what the American experience is like, the plight of people who, you know, have suffered under gun control, who have suffered under, like, as minorities, people who have suffered as women, and just, you know, like, what we can do to make the country a better country, maybe even attack some of the lies that have just been said on the campaign trail.
With all of that being said, it would have to come down to us having a very good president.
Yeah.
If it comes down to Trump being president, I don't see those things. I mean, they're on very opposite ends of.
I hear people saying that they would leave the country.
That's not far-fetched.
That's not far-fetched.
You don't, because I mean, like, if your rights are being stripped right before your face, I mean, kind of like they are now. Yeah, I would have a problem with that.
I mean, you really think that some of the ideas that he has, he'll be able to even make happen? Because, like,
yeah, he kind of is like that 1%.
I don't think the president has the ability to like make all Arab people wear numbers or like. Nah. Build a wall.
But let's be honest, it gets passed through just one other thing, which is like pretty much Congress.
Okay.
And then it moves on. And it's like, okay, that's what it is. Like, so I mean, like, it's kind of.
So if you're out there listening right now, make a comment on us how you feel about the State of the Union address. If you hear this after the State of the Union address, we would like to hear your opinions. If you was watching the Golden Globes, you know what I mean? We'd like to hear your opinions on that as well. Right now, we're about to jump into the song countdown. Your boy June prepared 5 dope songs for us to hear. 2 new songs that you probably never heard before. So we're going to get into that right now.
On the Culture Vulture Show, number 5, we got Big Sean, What a Year, featuring Pharrell. Let's do it. Culture Vulture, baby.
All I gotta say is, what a year, what a year. Whoa. I decided now that every year's our year. Oh yeah, man, that's till we disappear. Yeah. I'm focused on the near, never what's in the rear. Nah. Recently, I swear, man, we had so many accolades. I realize I ain't sat down, not even on a Saturday. Yeah, I'm going overtime, OT, like it's TNT in South America, rocking Rio with Riri, you know that's stadium status. When you started underground, you gotta make it to the attic. So I'm up in attic focus. Money is the only time I ADD. Going off more than ADT. Making power moves like back four, punch kick, ABB. Boy, this shit ABC. Shout out Detail. 7-Eleven, we on a roll. I'm on a 6th record off the album Going Gold. Last one woke the ass up like the morning show. I'm trying to make next year the greatest story ever told. Like, shit. Goddamn, standing next to J and K, like, man, never took it ever, brought him out. Damn, from where it's hard to make it this far when you're this 10, I'm saying. I'm little B with the right wrist. I realize time ain't money, it's priceless. So don't gas me up, bitch. I'm a hybrid. I know you like it. I see the jobs done before I see my eyelids. Getting better every single day, that's what they told me. And now I already wasn't fucking with the old me.
It's like I hit the light switch. I hit the light switch. It's like I took my family into a new crib. Then I hit the light switch. I took my whole life and then I hit the light switch.
Straight up.
So I'ma hop out and roll on them. Yeah, hop out and roll on them. It's like a fresh paradise, but I'm rolling on their life. I'ma roll on them.
Hey, what?
Hop out and roll on them.
4, we got Low Lives, Future featuring The Weeknd. You know what it is, Culture Vulture, baby.
I just took some Miley with us. Got some bitch from Fallas with us. She gon' fuck your squad with us. I'ma fuck her bras with us. Bitch from Pakistan with us. Ferraris in them lambs with us. About to fuck this club up with us.
Metro Boomin want some more, nigga.
I turn the Ritz into a pole house. It's like eviction number 4 now. Go ahead and that shit on the floor now. Girl, go ahead and show me how you go down. And I feel my whole body peeking. And I'm fucking anybody with their legs wide. Getting faded with some bitches from the west side. East coast, nigga, reppin' north side. Never waste a hoe's time. Bitch, I'm on my own time. Fuck a nigga, cosign. Always change my number and my phone line. Baby girl, I don't lie. Used to have no money for a crib. Now my room service bill cost your whole life. If they try to stem me, I go all out military. I'm camoed all out like I'm in the military. And free up all my niggas locked up in the penitentiary. Cause I'm always reppin' for the law life. Reppin' for the law life. Low life, low life, low life. No, I'm reppin' for the law.
That was Low Life. Now we getting into number 3, Fetty Wap, Grandma. Let's do it. Culture Vulture Show, baby. It is. It's the Culture Vulture Show. Right now, at number 2, we got Bryson Tiller, Self Righteous. Let's do it.
Thought it was better this way. Oh, trust me, baby, it's hard. Trying to give it up. I'm trying to, baby, it's tough. I guess it's my fault. I know what's up. Baby, we used to fuck. From now on, we make love. Let's catch up. Phone calls ain't enough. That's where I messed up. I should've kept in touch. Cause I ain't the type that would hit it and quit it. Even if it's mine, even if it isn't. Take them trips and pay your ass a visit. Gave you a portion, but you needed more, needed more. Now you won't even call me no more. Ain't laying naked in my sheets no more. I guess you ain't a freak no more. Oh, sex more, that's what I was on. Talk less, that's what I was on. Selfish, baby, I know. I know. Hey, quit
quick to admit it when I'm wrong. Said I was leading you on, now it's fuck me and leave you alone. Come love me, I need you at home. It's something about the way you scream in your mom. Now I'm the one who's been treating you wrong, contradicting all the things that I've been preaching in songs. Shit was going good, girl. Now it's looking bad, girl. Can we take it back, girl? Oh, no. You gave me a task, girl. Go clean up my act, girl. Done that where you at, girl?
Would you mind? Would you mind? Would you mind if I come do the things that you like? What you like? What you like?
Making the countdown for the second time is Fetty Wap, Zoo, shout out RGF, Culture Vulture, baby.
Money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Zoo guys, the saluters, show me coming through. Hey, watch how I turn up money, I throw it, what the fuck I do? Hey, niggas is phonin', bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Hey, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Hey, zoo guys, the saluters, show me coming through. Bitch with my ratchet, ay. Run up on the zoo, get your ass wet. And all the nigga ever do, get this cash lit. And you ain't heard of Zoo, be Zoo, you a savage. Ay. I'm from Jersey, what the fuck you thought, baby? Ay. And my bitches could not be broad, baby. Ay. I got money, bank account is already. You a worker, I'm a boss, stop playing. Disrespect the Zuby Zoo, bitch, they don't play that. Ay, automatic guns, bitch, we love to spray that. Ay, disrespect the Zuby Zoo, bitch, we don't play that. Wow, watch out, turn up money, I throw us, what the fuck I do? Ay, niggas is phoning, bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Ay, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Ay, zoo guys, bitch, saluters, show me coming through. Ay, watch out, turn up money, I throw us, what the fuck I do? Ay, niggas is phoning. Bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Hey, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Hey, two guys, bitch, saluters, only coming
soon. I got these bands on me. Damn, homie, why you broke? I blow your brand, homie. On one telly with your hoe, yo, bitch, a fan, homie. But that ain't new, I bet you know I'm sippin' red, homie. Sip that's a whoop, it got me slow down. Two up or nothing. Duh, you niggas disgust me. If it ain't about money, damn, then do not discuss me. Damn, my mama told me chill, said I chill at 50 mil. I got way too much to do, I got beats I need to kill. I got money I need to blow, bitches I need to know. Perp I need to blow, bitches parties out.
Watch y'all turn up money at doors, what the fuck I do? Ayy, niggas is phony, bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Ayy, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Ayy, zoo guys, bitch saluters, show me coming through. Ayy, watch y'all turn up money at doors, what the fuck I do? Ayy, niggas is phony, bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Ayy, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Ayy, zoo guys, bitch saluters, show me coming through.
Hey, niggas be on it, boy like they on it, smoking this chronic too. You niggas is homeless in these corners, what you want is cool. Money I throw it, money I blow it, we a fucking zoo. Nigga, I'm rolling, whip look stolen when I'm coming through. See you tomorrow, send me auto with extended clips. Give me a bottle, send in the hollows, niggas is running quick. Money and fast cars, only fuck bad bros. 100 degrees, I'm starting to see what niggas is mad for. My decorate the Uzi. Won't hesitate to use it. No. Get hella cake, I'm snoozing. Yeah. It's Monty Zoo, I'm cooling. My decorate the Uzi. Won't hesitate to use it. Yeah. My decorate the Uzi. Won't hesitate to use it.
Watch y'all turn up money at doors, what the fuck I do? Ayy, niggas is phony, bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Ayy, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Ayy, zoo guys, bitch saluters, show me coming through. Ayy, watch y'all turn up money at doors, what the fuck I do? Ayy, niggas is phony, bitches be honest, we the fucking zoo. Ayy, money and foreigns, niggas is ballin', who the fuck is you? Ayy, zoo guys, bitch saluters, show me coming through. Ayy.
Yeah, people, we're back, and We're going to our film corner, the Hollywood Hills. Let's do it.
Yo, right here in the Hollywood Hills, we're going to talk a little bit about the new Star Wars movie, Episode 7, The Force Awakens.
The Force is strong in my family.
This has been kind of controversial, just because the lead characters in the movie, we got a...
Talk about it.
We got a shorty.
Shorty. Female.
And then you got a knock. No, it's got, all right, so it stars a female lead and an African-American male lead. And there's been some controversy about that on the internet. Have you seen anything like that?
Of course, yeah. They're pretty much saying that a movie could never gross extremely high if it had a minority lead and a female lead. And we kind of have just attested that with Star Wars.
Well, all right. So some of the haters out there are also saying that it's the Star Wars franchise, and that regardless of who you put in that position, that you know what I mean? Like, Star Wars would have blew up.
It's gonna
sell.
There's so many fans, and even the fans that had, you know, their little like criticisms about it, they all love it. They all love it. It's Star Wars. It's all the same. It's about the action. It's about, you know, the plot twist and everything. And that's what it delivered.
I mean, if you get a chance to see the movie, you'll see that the development of the plot, very similar to Episode 4, but still had a lot of action, some great throwback references for the Force. I felt like it was something for people who have seen Star Wars before, like the older heads, and wanted something to relate to. You know what I mean?
For real.
I feel like one of the hate that that Episode 1, 2, and 3 got, the prequels, was that it was too new, the Jar Jar Binks character, how much the Force was. Like, everybody was hating on all of the new faction.
Yeah, I'm gonna say this though, like, people have to get tired of some of the same characters, excuse me, because it's just like, you know what I'm saying, you want something to be refreshed and renewed. You don't want to see the same thing. Somehow, if Anakin just were to appear, like, I'd be mad. I'd be like, I don't want to see this dude. I want new characters.
He got off a long time ago.
I know. New villains, you know what I'm saying? New plot twist. Yeah. And it did that. It served its purpose.
This is an opportunity for them to really reboot the franchise, give new characters for a new generation, but still at the same time pay homage to the old characters.
Yeah, now, what's interesting about this movie is that I seen a video on Worldstar Hip Hop. Shout out Worldstar. Shout out Q.
Worldstar.
You know what I mean? Whatchamacallit was, the whole situation was George Lucas wasn't a part of the creative process in this movie.
You know,
movie.
George Lucas got a black wife.
Yeah.
He
did not like the kind of, like, you know, the memes.
The
I'm
racism.
Sure. Yeah,
the
he didn't like that.
I'm sure. Not a lot of people did.
Nah.
It's a select group of people out there who are trying to spread that rhetoric. But, yeah. I mean, we can't let them hold us down, so.
Nah, man, seriously, like, he was saying that he sold it to white slavers, and that coming from, like, you know, that kind of icon. It's like,
oh, wow.
You know, yeah, those are his words. Those are his words.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So, but pretty much he was saying he had a whole other idea about the movie and everything, and what he was going to do to use the minority character and the female character. Yeah. And they kind of like shortchanged it, cause you noticed on the preview or whatever, they showed Homeboy with the lightsaber. You thought he's gonna be a Jedi, doing all kinds of, you know.
And then
didn't work out that way.
Yeah, he was more of a what we call a ban where I'm from. That's a bitch.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, there you go. New acronym, guys.
New acronym, bans, for all you bans out there. You tally bans. You auto bans. You bans on bans, throwing bans.
Yeah, man. But that was just us reporting live from the Hollywood Hills. That's our film segment we're going to be doing every week, so tune in. Moving on, now we're going into something interesting.
We're going to wrap up real quick with a segment that we like to call Bird of the Week.
Bird of the Week, let's do it.
All right, so
scrolling through the timeline.
So we here. Wait, what you calling yourself? You said Young Hazel? Hazel Dream?
Oh, Young Lavender?
Young Lavender.
Young Lavender today. So we're
Young Lavender scrolling through the gram, you know what I mean? And came upon a little beauty that we want all of y'all to follow right now.
Take a guess. She has 730K followers. Take a guess. Y'all know?
It is Irene the Dream back.
Irene the Dream back. That is at IreneTheDream back. Yeah. Yo, this post that she just posted 3 days ago with the caption, lights, camera, action, meet me. Hashtag Allure Nightclub and Ultra Lounge. Let's go. You almost went, yo.
Yo, she is bad.
Yo,
she's wearing the hell out of that dress, bro.
Yo, the dress with the slits, with the crazy slits.
Damn, it's so many pics of her.
20 hours ago, when she fucking with the king, she don't need any extras. Face beat.
She's getting money too. She's highly.
What is that beat? What is that? What is that face beat? Everybody been saying that recently.
Oh, face beat. That's like when girls put on makeup. It's like pretty much she threw on her. You know what I mean? Her concealer. You know what I'm saying? She got the blush on.
I'm old, man. I'm old. I'm from the time when you say something is beat, that means it's whack. That's whack.
No. Face beat is like a chick applying some makeup.
Oh, word.
Yeah,
well, no, face is definitely
beat.
Yeah, face is definitely beat.
Like how bad can mean good.
So that's the bird of the week, Irene the Dream back. Make sure that you follow her at IreneTheDream
back. Let's do it.
Yeah, let's do it. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed the show this week.
Any last remarks? Yeah, we'll see you next week, Tuesday, same time. You know how it goes, man. This is DJ June signing out. I also go by Travis, a.k.a. Young Lavender. Now, if you hit my gram and hit me with Young Lavender, you might get a little special surprise, a special shout-out on the show.
Yo, make sure that you follow him. Where they follow you at?
Follow me at Jersboy June, at two Jersboy underscores in that. June. It'll come up after Jers.
It'll come up after Jers. Make sure that you follow me at Then Douche Says. That's T-H-E-N-D-U-S-H-A-S-A-Y-S. And, you know, I mean, it's your boy Douche Holmes, a.k.a. City Magic, a.k.a. Young Vuitton, a.k.a. Purple Rooms, a.k.a. The Mobile Nobleman, a.k.a. You know what I mean?
Mr. Show You How to Jug. Shout out Fetty, shout out RGF.
Let me be your manager. Yo, shout out to everybody who made the countdown this week. Make sure you guys go run out and see that Star Wars. And I mean, Young June in the building.
You know what it is.
You already know. This has been
Culture Vulture.
Culture Vulture, episode one.
Episode one.
Culture Vulture.
Let's go.
Let's get it.
just got parted.